So we are today, we're going to talk about elegance in wine.
Yes.
So it is a little bit different. Today's topic will be different than last week's, because last week's more industry oriented. And also we were discussing about a topic like industry situation, investing in wine, how to buy wine, so on and so on. But today we'll be talking about only one word. So I think that's really interesting. And I think we can go really creative with that, with elegance in wine. So, I mean, I think, to be honest with you, I don't know what you think, but I think this word is a little bit overused.
Oh, definitely. That's why I wanted to talk about it.
Great. We are
beginning to hate the word.
Exactly. We have to pay the word to use.
Well, you suggested acidity in wine, and then I proposed to change that in elegance in wine. And it's something that I more often talk about, usually very shortly, because when I teach about wine and when we're tasting wines in WSET diploma, quite often students begin to talk about elegance and say, "Oh, it's such a beautiful wine because it's elegant." And I say, "What the hell does that mean?" You know, because since when is elegance actually a quality? It's a style. It's not a quality. Something totally different. Yeah. And then, and then I was reminded to that last week when I got the latest issue of a Dutch wine magazine called Perswijn. And the header of the, you know, on the front page, the cover was Bordeaux 2017. Too much rain, yet elegant. And I was thinking, What?
You know? Again?
To me, that reads like too much rain and therefore thin. It's probably not exactly what he meant. And I don't want to say that 2017 Bordeaux is thin, because I haven't tasted enough of 17 to have an opinion about that. But in a way, it feels a bit like that. And I was thinking, and actually, it's that title says exactly what I do not like about using the word elegant, because it's using obviously the word elegant as a quality. It says, you know, too much rain, yet elegant, meaning like, yet it's still good. You know,
it's and still good. Thinking,
yeah, but that makes no sense.
Sorry, go ahead. Yeah, there's a little bit delay in the conversation, so I'm not like trying to jump in. Actually, it's funny, because when I suggested the topic acidity in wine, and then you suggested elegance in wine, which I really like, and then it made me to think. So then when I thought about elegance, I started to think, okay, what is exactly elegance? Do we really relate it to the acidity or style? And then I looked up in the dictionary what elegance really means. In Oxford Dictionary, it says quality of being graceful and stylish in appearance or manner. And it's also used as simple and neatness. So then I thought about what elegance is mean for me in wine. To me, it's like I think what I use that word as elegance is like characteristics of like the qualities or if the wine is more refined or sophisticated or not too big and bold, I describe it as elegant. To me, it's like, first of all, like, it's not really, to me, elegance is not related at all in some certain flavors, but how these flavors perform itself within the structure of the wine.
Kind of. Yeah, but that's I think that's already the problem of the word, because it's open to still to quite different interpretations when you talk about wine, you know. And obviously, elegance is also a word that you can use for example, for people. Elegant people. But with wine, this is, I think, much less clear. Sure, you could say that, for example, Bourgogne is a more elegant wine than Bordeaux. In some respect, that is true, because, you know, it's less tannic, etc. But that doesn't make Bourgogne a better wine than Bordeaux. So it's not that I don't like the word elegant, but I don't like the way it is being used in wine. And actually, what you get now, for example, I remember a tasting two years ago, I think it was 3 years ago, it was tasting in Austria of 2016 vintage of the Österreichische well, of the Erste Lager wines. That's what mm-hmm. it was. Erste Lager wines. So it was a big tasting, a lot of people from everywhere. 2016 vintage, which was a good vintage, but 2015 is clearly the better vintage. It was warmer, true, had more alcohol, but with that, the wine also had more concentration, more length, more flavor, more complexity even. And then people were saying, oh, I like 16 so much. It's so beautifully elegant. Oh, okay. And it's better than 15, which was, you know, too big. It's not better. It's not at all. It's just a bit lighter and fresher, and apparently you prefer that style, but that's not the same as being better, you know. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's more drinkable, yeah, as a young wine, huh? Mm-hmm. But it's not the same as saying it's a better vintage. 15 mm-hmm. was better. It had more length, more. There was more to that vintage. Yeah. And that is where it begins to become a bit annoying, huh? And at the end, and the last thing I would like to say, well, not the last thing now, but what I would like to add to that, where does elegance end and thinness begin? And I noticed this more and more, like, for example, 14, well, in many regions in Europe, really a poor vintage. And then people start defending it and saying, yeah, it's so beautifully elegant. No, it's not. It's thin. It was unripe. It was really not a good vintage, you know, generally speaking. Some exceptions you always find.
Yeah. I think this word is used a lot with wine writers, consumers. Yeah. But it's also used a lot from like on the wine trade side, winemakers, importers, sellers, retailers. They like everyone at least has one elegant wine to.
True. But to sell. It's really, if you want to sell your wine, call it elegant.
Exactly.
Because it's used as a quality and that's only true to some extent.
So what is elegance for you?